The authors have no financial interest in the subject matter of this film. Laser in situ keratomeliasis, or LASIK, is currently the gold standard of refractive surgery and has gained wide acceptance due to excellent predictability, safety, and accuracy. Small incision lenticule extraction, or SMILE, challenges to change that and has the distinct advantage of being a flapless procedure. I never had a problem with creating flaps till the day I lost one. Even with extremely well-performed femtosecond laser-assisted LASIK surgeries, there were still unhappy patients, and I did not know why. Now, I started fearing flaps, and so did my patients. Then one day, someone told me about the new flapless procedure called SMILE. It was now possible to completely do away with the flap and all the complications that come with it.
New is always better, right? Always.
In highly experienced hands, the procedure looked incredibly simple. The lower interface of the intrastomal lenticule is created first, followed by the side cut, and then the upper interface, known as the cap. Following this, through the 2mm incision created by the laser, the anterior surface is dissected first, followed by the posterior surface, and finally the lenticule is extracted. Amazed by the surgery and the post-operative outcome, I decided to make the switch. However, when I started, it was not as easy as I thought, and I encountered various difficulties in the procedure. In my first case, I had a loss of suction. I had difficulties in dissection due to various opaque bubble layer patterns. Dissection was extremely difficult at times, and finding the correct plane of dissection was not all that easy. I encountered torn lenticules as well as cap tears. Once again, I was lost in all the questions. So I started looking for answers. In terms of refractive outcomes, both the procedures have been found to be comparable. SMILE is also reported to cause less dry eyes due to smaller incision and less severing of corneal nerves. Biomechanically, though there are conflicting reports, SMILE is believed to be more stable. I was finding answers, but the devils inside were not yet satisfied and continued to question me.
How do you know it causes less dry eyes?
To answer this question, we started the FS versus SMILE biomarkers project. Tears were collected using Schirmer strips in Eppendorf tubes, and they were transported to our research laboratory. This is our bank, where the samples are stored and retrieved at the time of analysis. Tear samples went through cytometric bead array analysis to look for inflammatory markers and mass spectrometry to look for molecular signatures. In this project, we found that LASIK showed increased inflammatory markers, increased extracellular matrix remodeling, and reduced wound healing as compared to SMILE.
I don't see any change in corvus or ORA. How do you say it's biomechanically better?
We answered this devil by first analyzing the corneal deformation using the Corvus ST. However, to make a model even more robust, we combined the functional data from the Corvus with structural data from the Pentacam and created an inverse finite element model. The inverse FEM showed that SMILE showed greater recovery of biomechanics post-operatively. So SMILE was found to be stronger in terms of biomechanics and showed greater recovery to preoperative levels.
Mm.
But the cell biology is not good enough. I'm still not convinced.
To get a better understanding of the cell biology, we performed LASIK and SMILE on contralateral cadaveric eyes and transported them to our laboratory. After preserving in liquid nitrogen, the samples underwent analysis for inflammation and markers for wound healing. We found that the markers for wound healing were increased in SMILE, indicating that SMILE showed better wound healing and rapid stabilization.
Are corneal nerves really preserved?
To check if corneal nerves are truly preserved in SMILE, we performed confocal microscopy in patients who underwent LASIK and SMILE in contralateral eyes. We found reduced corneal nerves in LASIK along with more areas of apoptosis and more activated keratocytes.
Why are my patients still not happy?
To find out why patients were still not happy, we performed a high-definition spectral domain OCT on them and found Bowman's microdistortions in both LASIK and SMILE. SMILE, however, showed a more rapid recovery to preoperative levels. We also found that cap ironing at the end of SMILE, though a simple procedure, helped reduce these microdistortions and improve visual quality post-operatively. The devils did go away, but each of them taught me a lesson, and I thank them for it. They helped me understand the procedure better and made me realize that the devil lies in the details. I was now free of doubts and slowly overcame the difficulties I was facing as I gained more experience. I was now ready to truly smile again.